गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन द सेशन टू ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 5 स्किल्स फॉर इंटरव्यूज वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट दैट इज ग्रुप डिस्कशन. सो ग्रुप डिस्कशन इज नथिंग बट टू अलाउ द एक्सचेंज इन्फॉर्मेशन एंड आइडियाज, गिव्स यू द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ वर्किंग इन अ टीम. सो इन प्लेस ऑफ workplace, discussion enables management to draw on the ideas and expertise of staff and to acknowledge the staff as valued members of team. So there are many advantages of group discussion. So let us see one by one. So due to group discussion, ideas can be generated, ideas can be shared, ideas can be tried out, ideas can be responded to by others. So group provide a support and growth for any endeavor. So group discussion is nothing but the exchange of information and ideas and gives you the experience of working in a team. So group discussion skill have many professional applications. So working in a group is a fun. So next is group discussion is categorized or classified in two types, that is structured and unstructured. So let us see what is structured group discussion and unstructured group discussion. So first is structured group discussion. So for structured group discussion, there are several roles assigned to get the best out of the discussion. So let us see in the structured group discussion which are the several roles. So first is initiator. He starts the topic of discussion. Then information seeker. His role is to ask questions related to the topic. Then next is a information giver. So his role is to answer any questions raised during the discussion. Then procedure facilitator. So he normally keeps track of the discussion by keeping minutes or notes. Then next, opinion seeker. On every point raised, this person asks the opinion of the others regarding the value of that particular item raised. So like the opinion seeker, opinion giver is also there. So he answers the opinion seeker and others. Then next is the classifier. So suggest extra data they may require in order to clear up any point. So the classifier is one of the again important one. And the last one is that is a summarizer. So summarizes the discussion. So initiator, information seeker, information giver, procedure facilitator, opinion seeker, opinion giver, clarifier and summarizer. So these are the several roles while the structured group discussion take place. Then next, some more roles become important while in a structural group discussion. So it will develop and opposing point of view begin to emerge. So social supporter is there. So social supporter, what is the role of this? Encourage the group when good points are raised. So this is social supporter. Then harmonizer, so tries to consider the benefits from two opposing points of view. Then tension reliever. So when GD tempers rise high, this person may try to consider the different angles raised. Then energizer. So tries to develop someone's good idea a little more. So it is energizer. Then compromiser. When the discussion becomes too heated, he tries to compromise from both the sides. Then gatekeeper, so encourage silent members to contribute. So these are also some roles which is important while in a structural discussion. So which develops an opposing points in structural group discussion. Then next, that is negative roles to be avoided. So while any group discussion, there is a negative roles also playing. So that we have to must be avoided. So degree related non-participant, so someone who does not contribute and whose presence inhibits the participation of other group members, so such a we have to take into consideration. Then attacker, someone who acts aggressively by experiencing disapproval of other members and their contributions to the discussion, so that attacker. Then dominator, someone who takes control of the discussion by talking too much, interrupting other members, or behaving in a patronizing way. Then clown, someone who shows off, refuses to take the discussions seriously, or disputes it with inappropriate humor. So in this session we have discussed unstructured group discussion, so which roles are played and which are the negative roles are there. So in this session we have covered the group discussion with the structured group discussion. So in the next session we are going to see the next part, that is unstructured group discussion. Thank you.